The National Center for Health Statistics reports that in 2021, the last year with available numbers, nearly 2,000 Oklahomans died from stroke, or roughly 43 per 100,000 residents. And that death rate is higher in our rural areas. Now, the USDA is offering a large grant to help rural health providers provide better preventive care. Taylor Jackson joins us now with the details on that. Taylor.
That's right, Rich. The USDA awarded OU Health Science Center nearly $500,000 to help rural communities connect with healthcare providers in Oklahoma County.
Thanks to the United States Department of Agriculture, Oklahomans in rural communities now have access to telestroke services.
Well, we believe under the Biden administration that healthcare is a universal right, and we want to make sure people have access to not only health care, but quality care.
The funding comes from the USDA Rural Development Distance Learning and Telemedicine Grant Program.
Well, with the funds from the USDA, we're able to purchase carts, and these telehealth carts have the ability to receive audio and video and allow for us to interface with a spoke site, like a rural hospital site.
OU Telestroke Program Medical Director Dr. Shin Jin says rural hospitals will be able to contact OU Health for stroke emergencies using the telestroke technology.
The individuals at the other hospital can define that the patient has a stroke, and they at their fingertips can basically call us and get one of our neurologists to assist in the care of that stroke patient and deliver what we have here, our expertise, remotely.
The telestroke care will be available to Oklahomans in 23 locations around the state, including Ellis, Grady, and Roger Mills County. Since the COVID-19 pandemic, telehealth services have become increasingly popular, and for some, it's a necessity.
I would say in the state of Oklahoma, that need has always existed. When we look at the state of Oklahoma and looking at all the hospitals and what they have, you know, for care, some of our counties don't even have a hospital in the county, and some of them only have the one.
According to the CDC, people who live in rural communities are more likely to die prematurely than residents of urban communities. Cancer, diabetes, heart disease, and stroke are some of the main health issues residents in rural areas face. The American Heart Association recommends that people get regular checkups to help minimize health problems.
So to be aware of your blood pressure and to really stay on top of those things, work with a physician, work with your doctor so that, you know, when something becomes an issue that you can get ahead of it and start a plan before it really becomes a medical emergency.
Stroke survivor Gary Bulmer experienced his stroke more than 40 years ago and still experiences the effect of a stroke today.
I can tell people I had a surgically implanted short-term memory deficit. And I say that and people are like, what are you talking about? And I'm like, exactly. You know, so you can't tell it. That's why it's called, our movement is called the Walking Wounded or the Silent Epidemic.
Bulmer underwent an extensive 13-hour surgery. Stroke symptoms to look out for include face drooping, arm weakness, and speech difficulty.
It's so important to get medical care as quickly as possible. And that can be hard in those rural areas, you know, where unfortunately a lot of hospitals are shutting down across Oklahoma. And so we don't always have that immediate care available. So the telemedicine stuff is huge. That's so needed in our state.
Oklahoma State Director Kenneth Korn says the USDA has created partnerships around the state to help fill that need.
We truly believe that a zip code should not define what type of care you get. And so that's the mission of the administration through rural development.
In 2022, the USDA established a new program to support healthcare in rural areas called the Emergency Rural Healthcare Grant. The grant was totaled $42 million and assisted more than a million Americans in rural communities.
The administration did emergency rural healthcare grants all throughout our state. Oklahoma, we did $11 million in grants throughout Oklahoma to rural hospitals and ambulance services.
Korn says the USDA plans to continue its investment in rural Oklahoma.
Many of these communities can't afford to make these type of investments, and some of the dollars that they're getting back are from Washington is money that we're paying in tax dollars. And we want to spend that money here in Oklahoma, not let it go to, you know, Texas or California or New York. It needs to be spent here so our people have access to health care.
If you or a loved one experiences stroke symptoms like face drooping, severe headache, or confusion, call 911 for help.